Welcome back to my class. In my first class, I told about you how to measure the density of regular solids and irregular solids. Also, I gave introduction about relative density, its unit, its formula, etc. Today, we'll see about relative density bottle. It is a device to measure the relative density of liquids. So, let us go through. So, this is the diagram of relative density bottle. Its construction is very simple. It is a small glass bottle provided with a stopper and a capillary tube. So when the liquid whose RD we have to measure is put inside this bottle, the extra liquid comes out through the capillary tube. So this is also known as specific gravity bottle. What is its other name? Specific gravity bottle. Sometimes relative density bottle, other name also than specific gravity bottle. So how to measure the relative density of liquid using this? Let us go through your activity 4. In this, what is happening? First, you have to wash the relative density bottle with distilled water and make it dry, allowed for dry, then measure its mass. Let the mass of the relative density bottle is m1. Then pour distilled water inside this bottle. Then again measure the mass. Means this time you are measuring the mass of bottle and water. This is m2. So empty bottle mass is m1. Mass of bottle plus distilled water is m2. So we can find out the mass of water here. Mass of water will be m2 minus m1. So after removing this water, the liquid whose relative density you have to measure, pour the liquid inside this. Then mass of bottle plus mass of liquid, together it is coming m3. We know mass of empty bottle is m1, mass of bottle and liquid is m3. So mass of liquid can be calculated as m3 minus m1. So what's the formula of relative density of the liquid? m3 minus m1 divided by m2 minus m1. So this is the formula have to remember. Next, another device also there, that is known as hydrometer. With the help of hydrometer also, we are able to measure the relative density of liquids. Its construction also very simple. So it is an instrument used to measure the relative density of liquid. It is made up of glass, consists of a cylindrical stem. This is known as cylindrical stem, provided with a bulb-like structure at the bottom. So down of the bulb, some mercury bulbs are provided here. So you see, it consists of a cylindrical stream and a bulb weighted with mercury or lead salts to make it float upright. So the liquid which is to be tested is put in this beaker. So by seeing the level of liquid, which one touching to the hydrometer, we can find out the relative density of liquid, because the wall of the hydrometer is having graduation marks. By seeing this mark, we can find out directly the relative density of liquids. Now come to the point, flotation and sinking. So when a solid is put inside a liquid, there are two chances. First chance, it may sink. Second chance, it may float. So, in which condition the object will float, in which condition the object will sink? If the density of the object or solid is more than the density of liquid, then the object will sink. If the density of solid is less than the density of liquid, then the object will sink. These are the conditions for which a body will float or sink. Next comes to the application of flotation. There are so many applications. So first one, you see, relative density of candle wax is 0.93. So any object which is made up of wax float on water, because density of candle is less than density of water. Similarly, sea water is denser than river water. Why sea water is denser than the river water? Because of lots of salt dissolved in it. So therefore, it is easier to swim in sea water than in river water. Similarly, the density of ice is less than that of water. So ice should float in water. So similarly, ice box also float in sea water. Next, some river water has lower density than sea water, and a ship loaded with cargo submerges more in river water than in sea water. That's why a plimsoll line is provided in the ship. Up to that marking only the ship can be loaded. If the load is beyond that plimsoll line, then it runs the risk of sinking. The ship can sink. So thank you, children. We'll continue next class the rest part of this lesson. So learn it, practice it. Thank you.